wake up everybody, no more sleeping in bed, no more backward thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There is so much hatred, war and poverty.
Teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. 'Cause they're the ones who's coming up, and the world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can. Oh yeah.
The world won't get no better if we just let it be. Change again, just you and me.
Wake up all the doctors, make the old people well. They're the ones who suffer and who catch all the pills. They don't have so very long before their judgment day. So won't you make them happy before they pass away? Oh yeah.
The morning I wake up, just for the breath of life, I thank my maker. My mom say I come from hustlers and shakers. My mind building on skyscrapers and acres. He said, take us back to where we belong. I try to write a song as sweet as the Psalms. Though I'm the type to bear arms and wear my heart on my sleeve. Even when I fell in God, I believe. Read the days and weave through the maze and the seasons. So amazing, feed them and raise them. Seasons are aging, earthquakes, wars and rumors. I want us to get by, but we more than consumers. We more than shooters, more than looters. Created in this image so God lived through us. And even in this generation, living through computers only love.
Welcome to the University of Delaware and Delaware Stadium for today's ceremony commemorating the graduation of the Avon Grove High School class of 2021. My name is Scott DeShong, and I'm the principal at Avon Grove High School. On behalf of our faculty and staff, the school district administration, and the board of school directors, we are pleased to have the class of 2021, families, caregivers, and special guests here in person with us this morning. At this time, please stand if you are able and remove your caps as Avon Grove High School senior Juliana Brescia performs the national anthem.
Oh, see, can you see? So proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the
Thank you, Juliana. You may be seated. Before I make my comments this morning, I would like to recognize members of the class of 2021 for their commitment to the armed forces of our country. Students, when I call your name, would you please stand and remain standing until I ask you to be seated? The following students have made a commitment to the armed forces of the United States. Alana Boyardi, United States Air Force Reserve Officer Training Corps at Colorado State University. Ethan Boyle, United States Navy. Nicholas D'Antonio, United States Coast Guard. Taylor Finicaro, United States Army Reserve Officer Training Corps at Widener University. Anthony Geller, United States Air Force. Max Haas, United States Air Force Reserve Officer Training Corps at Embry-Riddle Aeronautical University. Ryan Kelly, United States Army. Landon LaFrance, United States Army. Jocelyn Martinez, United States Army National Guard. Evan McCleary, United States Navy Reserve Officer Training Corps at Virginia Polytechnic Institute and State University. Sadie Natris, United States Navy Reserve Officer Training Corps at Villanova University. Yareli Ortiz Castaneda, United States Army National Guard. Joseph Smiley, United States Marine Corps. Caleb Smith, United States Army Reserve Officer Training Corps at Shippensburg University. Javier Zavala, United States Army National Guard. I would like to personally thank each of you for your commitment to our country and to its values. Thank you for your willingness to protect our freedom. Godspeed to each of you. Please join me in both congratulating and thanking these young people for their decisions. You may be seated. The class of 2021 features members of the Avon Grove High School competitive cheer team that finished second in the entire state of Pennsylvania, future educators who dedicated a significant portion of their year working with students in classrooms throughout our school district, and first responders who put the needs of our community before the needs of themselves. I could certainly list many, many more accomplishments, but the story of the class of 2021 is, as you can imagine, somewhat different. On March 13, 2020, the course of the Avon Grove High School class of 2021 was permanently altered. What most of us thought would be a nice little two-week break turned into the true story of the class of 2021. So in this year, in 2021, successfully navigating the last year of high school and a pandemic is the real accomplishment. In other words, each and every member of the class of 2021 is a significant accomplishment. Students, your senior year experience didn't necessarily take place in classrooms, but it took place in bedrooms, in kitchens, and living rooms. Honestly, wherever you could get a Wi-Fi signal. If you were in school, even for just part of the year, your experience was masked and distanced, always one step away from a COVID outbreak, sending you home to your bedroom, kitchen, or living room. In other words, school certainly did not look like school. You were either images on a screen or masks and plexiglass. You, class of 2021, are the accomplishment. So, look what you've done. In the face of uncertainty, you pressed on. You adapted, you finished, you supported one another. You gutted it out, even when the end seemed beyond reach. You, class of 2021, are the accomplishment. Honestly, if this is what you're able to overcome, I am really, really struggling to figure out what you cannot. Congratulations on this accomplishment. Eighty-five percent of this class will continue their education after they graduate today. They will attend over 100 different schools throughout the United States. Members of this class will attend Brown University, the University of Pennsylvania, and Notre Dame. They will attend the School of the Art Institute of Chicago, Penn College of Technology, and the Automotive Training Center in Exton. Class of 2021 graduates will extend themselves as far west as the University of Cal Berkeley, as far north as Montana State University, and as far south as the University of Miami. Seniors, on behalf of the faculty and the staff of the school district, we are proud of what you've accomplished, both inside and outside of the classroom. You've become the type of people that make your family, your school, and your community extremely proud. We have high expectations for your future success and the impact that you will have on the world. You, class of 2021, are the accomplishment. Do not let today be the pinnacle of your achievements. Be proud to have earned the status of Avon Grove High School graduate and use it as a springboard to future success. Always strive to do better and win every day. You either get better or you get worse. You don't stay the same. Be humble in your victories and resilient in your setbacks. You will not go through life undefeated. Embrace being uncomfortable. Growth begins at the end of your comfort zone. Finally, your ability to do something isn't always based on what other people say you do well. The one who wins the race in the long run, usually is not the strongest or the fastest, but the one who's worked the hardest. Parents, family members, guests, school district administrators, and board of school directors, it is my honor and privilege to present to you the Avon Grove High School class of 2021. At this time, I would like to introduce the president of the class of 2021, Amber Hayward, to deliver her senior speech.
Hello, everyone. So first, I wanted to start by thanking everyone for coming out to support us seniors, whether you're here in person or at home. Thank you very much. I had a lot of trouble thinking of what to say to you all today. I've thought about this speech for 3 years now, but I always came up short. I felt like I had to say the perfect thing, and I was overwhelmed by the idea of speaking to my community, all the people I grew up with. And so, when I face something difficult, I usually turn to art to make sense of how I'm feeling. This time, it was a song called Before the World Was Big. It played one night while I was driving. And I'm not going to serenade you all today, don't worry, but the last two lines of the song really struck me. They go, I just miss how it felt standing next to you, wearing matching dresses before the world was big. That night, while I was driving, I suddenly felt like a little kid again. I remembered my younger sister, when we were little, walking up the street to the bus stop that seemed miles away, how we used to wear matching clothes, and how I used to stretch as hard as I could just to be able to look over my kitchen counter. My older sister, a teenager at the time, seemed so grown up and wise and cool, and I was so excited to be like that one day. Now, it only takes me 10 seconds to drive up that street. My sister and I buy our own clothes, and I don't think twice walking by my kitchen counter. But I don't feel grown up or wise or so cool like I expected I would. I think part of me was convinced that getting older would magically make life make sense, that I would enter the world a real adult with complete confidence. Now that I'm here, I find myself wishing the world was still small. I'm scared it's going to swallow me whole the moment I step into it. But the more that I thought about it, the more I realized that the world was never really that small or simple. The first time I rode a school bus, I remember being incredibly nervous. It was so big and so yellow. All the kids in the back looked so old, and the seats were all taller than me. But now, thinking of the bus, it feels small and awkward, and I honestly cannot remember the last time that I rode one. I realized that when I was little, the world seemed just as big and scary as it does to me right now. Yet, the most important thing that I have to remind myself is that I am not the only one. And that's what I want to share with you all today. Not just those graduating with me, but everyone who's here to support them too. It's okay to not be 100% sure, to feel like you don't know what you're doing. You're not alone. Everyone around you is just guessing as they go. We're all just kids navigating a big, scary world. And not too long ago, we actually were just kids navigating something new and something scary. look where we are now. Today is about looking to the future, celebrating everything that we have accomplished and everything we will accomplish. I want to congratulate you all on getting here today. It definitely was not easy, and it's something to be incredibly proud of. And as you step into that big, scary world, remember you're not taking that step alone. The world you're stepping into isn't empty. It's filled with people who are figuring out life just like you. So have some compassion for yourself and the people around you. And remember, you're never as alone as you think you are. Y también quiero decir algo en español porque sé que no soy la única con familia que habla español. No voy a decir mi speech entero en español, pero para sumar, quiero decir que la vida puede ser difícil, pero nunca, nunca estás sola en la vida. Entonces, muchas gracias, felicitaciones, buena suerte. So thank you, congratulations, and good luck to all of you.
Thank you, Amber. At this time, I would like to introduce the valedictorian of the class of 2021, Joseph Dagher.
Hi, everyone. Seniors, congrats. It's been quite a journey and a challenging one at that. Our high school experience has been a blindfolded roller coaster with no shortage of twists, turns, ups, downs, and loops. And in the blink of an eye, it seems as though we've sped from being decked out in yellow for color wars to putting on our caps and gowns today. Although our senior year may not have unfolded exactly as we envisioned it as freshmen, I'm incredibly appreciative of the tireless effort that our teachers, faculty, and families have devoted to our success throughout high school, both before the pandemic and during it, which I never thought I'd need to specify. But I think I speak for all my peers when I say thank you for everything. In March of 2020, I remember the days leading up to the shutdown when the halls were filled with talks of if, when, and how long we would get out of school for. It's kind of funny to think that Mr. Murray's prediction was that we'd go out for a few days for a cleaning break, but that would be it. Well, that was an understatement. However, his prediction was no further off than anyone else's at the time. I never thought that the majority of our senior year would end up through a computer screen, and not one of us did. Yet, as a testament to our perseverance, we still conquered it. Those first couple months of lockdown were our very first look at just how drastically different the rest of our high school years would turn out to be. And although the pandemic caused us to miss out on many of the traditional high school events, it gave us a unique opportunity to learn many invaluable lessons that most people don't learn until later in life, not to mention the limited edition yard signs that we got. The unexpected break from our usual bustling lives offered us the chance to step back and reflect on what we value most about normalcy. I never thought I'd miss the chilly morning drives to school or passing friends in the cramped hallway traffic, but thanks to COVID, I won't ever take those things for granted again. As restrictions are lifted and we approach a mask-free future, I hope you won't either. While it's still fresh in our minds, be sure to take note of everything you've wished for and missed over the past year. Unless we make a conscious effort to be grateful for each and every day, you won't realize what you have until it's gone. And no, I'm not just talking about a national toilet paper shortage. We've also well learned that nothing is ever guaranteed. And because of that, we should be constantly thankful for the one thing that actually is guaranteed, the present. We can and should plan for the future, but we shouldn't fixate on it or attempt to control it because chances are it won't quite turn out the way we initially pictured it. I never thought our graduation would be sat in bleachers or spaced 6 feet apart, but who could have predicted that? As the roller coaster of high school pulls back into the station, we're buckling up for an entirely new, even more exciting ride. The next few years will fly by even quicker than the last, so make every moment count. Life's curveballs are far from over, so be grateful for what you have in the present, look back proudly on your past, and work passionately to a brighter future. It was a privilege to be your classmate, and despite all the uncertainty and challenges I never thought we'd have to conquer over the past 4 years, I always knew we'd proudly graduate as Avon Grove's class of 2021 with the best still yet to come. Thank you and congratulations.
Thank you, Joe. At this time, I'd like to introduce the salutatorian of the class of 2021, Ben Nelson.
You can take your mask off.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Thank you, Mr. DeShong. I would also like to thank all of the teachers, administrators, students, and parents who helped put this event together. Though it's been a difficult year, we all appreciate some semblance of normalcy with this ceremony. For those of you who don't know me, hi, Ben Nelson, middle initial A, class of 2021. Many of you probably know someone in one of your classes who always thought he knew the answer. I'm seeing a few nods. Yeah, that was me, but don't hold that against me because I was usually right. Okay, so it's finally over, high school. 4 years of stress, tests, questionable lunch food, and studying. Or in my case, trying to study while my younger brother played some new game called Fortnite. For many of you, I'm sure you're more than ready for high school to be over. Early onset senioritis set in at about the end of sophomore year. But there are some here today that wish we had just one more day. There has to be at least one, right? Since we were those tiny, innocent freshmen, the world around us has changed considerably. TikTok has delighted the senses and killed the brain cells of millions. A small, wrinkled green alien, known only by the name of Baby Yoda, has become immortalized in rap songs, memes, and plush toys. We let a cylindrical speaker called Alexa hear and record all of our conversations. And Blake Shelton is supposed to marry Gwen Stefani. I don't know if we should laugh or cry. Changes, however, are not just limited to our surroundings. We have also changed a lot during these past 4 years. From freshmen during color wars, rip color wars, traveling in herds to ward off larger predators, to seniors saying, "How are those freshmen so small?" But size is not the only change. The amount of food thrown across the lunchroom has gradually decreased over these past 4 years. Bottle flipping contests have almost completely disappeared. And I haven't seen anyone accidentally staple themselves since sophomore year. We all started out in high school as wide-eyed innocents, not really sure who we were or who we wanted to be. When we chose our electives in that first year, our choices were based more on what our friends were doing than what we wanted to do. But as the years passed, as we matured, our decisions became truly our own, not our friends, parents, or teachers. Then, when we were all trapped in our bedrooms, going to school while lounging in our beds, not sleeping, just resting our eyes, our development into adults was accelerated. We were forced to take charge of our own education, and it was up to us whether we continued to succeed or not. We had to have serious philosophical discussions with ourselves about what we thought we needed from school and how to get it. If that isn't sufficient to prepare us for adult life, then I don't know what is. We've all grown up immensely, both physically and mentally, in our high school career. From day one to day 720, yes, I did do the math, all of our experiences in between have brought us here, to today, to this moment. And as you look forward to what your lives will look like beyond high school, I hope you remember this moment. Because even if you didn't appreciate every moment of high school, it was your time here that made you into the person you are today. Thank you, and I wish you all the best of luck.
Thank you, Ben. On Tuesday, June 8th, more than 90 students were recognized at the Senior Scholarships and Awards Program. These students received over $154,000 in scholarships and awards from our school and our community. Would the students honored at the Senior Awards Program please stand and be recognized at this time? You may be seated. According to our senior survey, the class of 2021 has been awarded over $3.1 million in scholarships, which will be used to further their education beyond high school. Will each student receiving a scholarship please stand at this time and be recognized for your achievements? You may be seated. It is my pleasure to invite Nancy Castano Flores to the stage to share her senior speech.
Sorry. Good morning. Buenos dias. My name is Nancy Castano Flores, and I am grateful to be standing here to present to you this speech. I want to start off by thanking the administration, faculty, and staff at Avon Grove High School who have worked diligently every day in order to provide us with a better education and a wonderful place for us to come and learn. I also want to give a big thank you to the teachers, parents, and guardians who have helped and supported us, the class of 2021, throughout these 4 years of high school. We could never thank you enough for all that you do in order to motivate and keep us going. Thank you for always looking out and ensuring that we made it all the way to where we are today. I'd like you all to close your eyes for a second. I'll wait. I want you to take a moment and imagine what the American dream looks like. Now open your eyes. The American dream is sitting next to you, in front of you, and behind you. It is us graduating today. The American dream can have many different definitions. To some, it may mean religious freedom. To others, it can be economic growth. And for most of us, it is having a better education. I would now like to share with you what the American dream means to me. While it is said that parents will move mountains for their children, mine actually moved countries for my brothers and I. My parents and I came to this country 18 years ago when I was only 4 months old. My parents wished to provide me with a better future that sustained opportunities and eliminated hardships they once experienced. In these 18 years of my life, I have learned three valuable things that I believe will help you attain your American dream: compassion, perseverance, and being a luchona. The first two you may recognize, but the third is one I'll explain. Luchona, luchona is a term understood in the Hispanic community that refers to those people who strive and do whatever it takes in order to achieve their goals. The community that we come from has some of the most hardworking luchones and luchonas I have ever met. Some of you parents and most people in here probably work two jobs, night shifts or extra hours, in order to provide for your family. I want you to know that your hard work does not go unnoticed and that you are the body of the American dream we are all living today. My parents came to this country with nothing. They suffered and struggled, But thank you to them, I stand here today, and I can proudly say that I'm a Mexican-born female who is also a first-generation high school graduate. Next fall, I will be attending college, pursuing a degree in education, looking to fulfill my American dream. Now, in order for my parents to understand how grateful I am for all that they have done, I would like to translate this piece for them. Mamá y papá, ustedes llegaron a este país sin nada, sufrieron y lucharon, pero gracias a ustedes estoy aquí y puedo decir con orgullo que soy una mujer nacida en México que también es primera generación en graduarse de la prepa. En unos meses iré a la universidad en busca de cumplir con mi sueño americano. Todos mis logros son dedicados hacia ustedes y quiero decirles que estoy bien agradecida por todo el amor y cariño, apoyo que me han dado. Gracias, mamá y papá, los quiero. Now, before I close off, I want to share with you a quote said by Barack Obama. He said, "We may come from different places and have different stories, but we share common hopes and one very American dream." Thank you and good luck to the class of 2021.
Muy bueno, señorita, muchas gracias. That was wonderful. Thank you, Nancy. It gives me great pleasure now to announce Raul Lopez to perform his senior speech.
Good morning, everyone. First of all, thank you so much for joining us today. You know, it really is my honor to be able to speak in person in front of all of you. It makes me so happy we're all here, healthy, happy. Having said that, isn't it weird to think that today is most likely the last morning the class of 2021 will all be in the same place at the same time? I mean, it's fascinating, it's bittersweet, but it's definitely scary. It's almost funny, actually. I've spent the last couple years of my life dreaming about today, but now that I stand here before you, I can't pinpoint exactly what it is I feel. I want to start off by saying how proud I am of every single one of you. Whether you knew me personally, or if I was just another face to you during your time here, all of us have had to sacrifice, stress, and work to be here. There is no doubt about it. So many things proved themselves uncertain through the course of last year, to the point where every day we expected something to go wrong. Everything and everyone seemed restless, but as a community, we persevered and we pushed through, and for that reason, I can confidently say how proud I am to be here. As we get ready to move on to the next stages of our lives, I ask that you please reflect for a moment. Seniors, look to your left, and please look to your right. Look behind you and in front of you, and acknowledge that all 400 plus of us are about to graduate high school. Take the time to reach out to those you've lost touch with and let them know how proud you are of them. And please, take the time to mend relationships where possible. If today is about us, we cannot celebrate without being together first. I once heard that a lesson learned should be a lesson shared, and today I wish to pass some words on to you. These last 2 years of high school have proven to me how pivotal relationships can be, but unfortunately, it took me too long to realize this. For those of you who know me, I was constantly caught up in school. The way things seem and the way things are often get confused for one another, and looking back to me, the way things seemed were that if I did not put 100% of my attention to my studies, I would not be able to achieve what I set for myself. I would go out of my way to join whatever club I could, apply to whatever position I could, and establish myself as what I thought an ideal AG student should be. But why? I became so entranced with this idea that I stopped cultivating relationships in my life. I constantly said no to plans when I very well knew it was just because there was something to be done. And that something could have waited to be completed. When it wasn't homework, it was a meeting. If it wasn't a project, it was this creeping fear of not living up to the expectation I had set for myself and fit the image other people saw of me. And standing up here today, I look back and see this. Personal gain is not worth it at the expense of relationships with others. There were countless times where a simple yes would have not derailed me. And for a good portion of my junior and senior year, I lived my life through stories my friends told or pictures others uploaded to social media. Fortunately, all that work did pay off. I'm happy to be attending the college I am, and I feel satisfied with the mark I'm leaving on AG. I am not telling you to stop caring about something you feel passionate for. That is what life is about. But I urge you to take this lesson to heart sooner rather than later. Could you imagine if we had learned this after retirement? If we had spent our entire careers prioritizing money or a position over family and friends? Most people you meet will be so much more valuable to you and your goals than you may realize. I look at every single one of you, and I am unbelievably proud to be graduating alongside you. Moving here 7 years ago wasn't easy, but my experience here at Avon Grove was one to remember. Class of 2021, here we go. We are about to make a great leap, and to extend the sink or swim metaphor we're all familiar with, it's important to know that we do have a support system surrounding the pool or waving at us back on shore. The more times we embrace the uncertainty of the future and cannonball ride in, the more confident we will all be. I wish you all the best of luck in your futures, but I can confidently say once more, wherever life takes you, I know we will all be okay. Thank you so much and congrats. You guys all deserve this.
Great message, Raul, thank you. Now we will hear from our senior ensemble under the direction of Mrs. Amanda Wilcox as they perform Omnia Soul, composed by Z. Randall Stroop.
Somewhere far from north.
Hello, everyone. I'm back. Okay. So for this next part of the ceremony, I would like to invite my fellow officers to the stage. Morgan Levy, Vice President. Kayla Caron, Secretary. Gia Sapone, Treasurer. And Amelia Hartle, Communications Officer. Sorry, we had a quick photo op. All right. I would also like to invite the officers of the class of 2022. Darby Benkoski, President. Siddich Kochar, Vice President. Susan Deering, Secretary. Riley Beck, Treasurer. And Lloyd Degnan, Communications Officer. So, we are about to do the passing of the guard, and we want to wish the class of 2022 much luck for their senior year.
Students, parents, caregivers, family members, and special guests, the time has finally come to officially recognize each member of the Avon Grove High School class of 2021. At this time, I would like to introduce Mrs. Ashley Penn, the Avon Grove High School Dean of Students and Senior Class Advisor, who has the pleasure of announcing the graduates as they receive their diplomas.
Mr. Joseph Dager. Benjamin Andrew Nelson. Amber Lee Hayward. Camille Morgan Levy. Kayla Ann Caron. Giovanna Marie Zappone.
Congratulations.
Amelia Elizabeth Hartle.
Congratulations.
Caitlin Alexa Cornett. Anna Huntley Benjamin. Elizabeth Grace Harrison. Sophia Victoria Strajewski. Francesca Campbell McGregor. Nancy Castaño Flores. Raul Lopez. Miranda Joy Adler. Liliana Rose Bauman. Paul Sabine Clark.
Congratulations.
Abigail Rebecca Conliff.
Congratulations.
Danielle Elizabeth D'Angelo.
Congratulations.
Ren Duff.
Congratulations.
Alex Alvarino Farina. Reese Jamison Ibel Farrell. Nicholas Michael Giampolo. Catherine Reeves Jadero. Ava Adriana Gray. Jessica Price Griffith. Max Joseph Haas.
Congratulations.
Aiden Gregory Hannon.
Congratulations.
Aiden Jacob Kempista.
Congratulations.
Daniel James Kozel.
Congratulations.
Riley Paige Lawson.
Congratulations.
Stephen Kin Hun Louis.
Congratulations.
Damian Philippe Manchevsky. Ashlyn Nicole McDonald.
Congratulations.
Riley Elizabeth Myers. Levi Miel Morel. Sadie Faith Natris.
Congratulations.
Kylie Lynn Norris. Beatrix Seraphine Novak. Sean Stephen O'Connor. James Patrick O'Hora. Aiden Leslie Parente. Mary Ellen Roberts. Quinn Samuel Slavin.
Congratulations.
Caleb Daniel Smith. Caitlin Elizabeth Sweet. Isa Saman Syed. Kayla Elizabeth White. Nicole Lynn Whitman. Mackenzie Ann Adair. Dana Paola Aguilar. Alexander Aguilar Dominguez. Ulises Aguilar Bedoya. Noah Austin Alberti. Tucker Edward Aliberti.
Congratulations.
Finn William Allison.
Congratulations.
Chad Thomas Anderson. Adam Joseph Apashin. Maria Elizabeth Arce. Joshua Alexander Aaron Sebia. Jesus Arivalo. Quetzali Aureli Arizmendi Cordova. Mason Alexandra Arnaldi. Henry Arroyo. Ulises Arroyo Aguilera. Delaney Ann Ashworth. Jocelyn Denise Ayala Escobar. Mariela Lisbeth Ayala Lopez. Liam James Bachman. Mackenzie Grace Bachman. Peyton Elizabeth Bachman. Nicholas Jurgen Ballreich. David Paul Barlow. Brittany Jessica Barnes. Nathaniel Hughes Barnett. Destiny Liani Barreto. Edson Fidel Berrios Maceiro. Nathaniel Ezio Belfiore. Evelyn Beltran Romo. Gabriel Manuel Bertolino. Kendall Vivica Blanchard. Catherine Dawn Bogetta. Alana Celine Boyardi. Alexander Roland Bollicker. Dylan Alexander Bolt. Brandon Maxwell Bond. Trenton Eckert Bonner. Anthony Joseph Borgini. Claire Draper Hamilton Bowden. Abigail Nicole Boxler. Madison Ann Boxler. Ethan James Boyle. Sam Ross Bradley. Walker Gerald Bredicus. Juliana Rose Brescia. Julian Sterling Brown. Jennifer Ann Bruix. Brady Eric Buckwald.
Congratulations.
James Brant Buffington. Megan Noel Campbell. Aiden Blaze Carden.
Congratulations.
Ava Rose Carlin. Brian William Cassidy. Brian Castaneda Arroyo. Aiden Michael Calder. Anne Elizabeth Cavalier. Skylar Michael Childs. Abigail McKenna Church. Salvador Jose Centoro Murillo. Benjamin Andrew Clark. Logan William Clendaniel. Carrington Jolie Colon. Kayla Marie Connors. Aiden Jacob Cordial. Jacqueline Cordova. Alexis Cordova Bernal. Alyssa Rose Corsero. Emma Marie Cotton. Kaylin Renee Cousin. Madeline Marie Crawford. Sophia Elizabeth Crossan. Catherine Margaret Cruciano. Melanie Ive Cruz. Jacob Warren Culbertson. Emma Grace Curtis. Sydney Marie Curtis. John Stevenson Cuthbert. Caroline Elizabeth Serpak. Brody Allen Daddis.
Congratulations.
Brooke Ann Daddis.
Congratulations.
Savannah Gracius Daly. Evan Emmanuel D'Ambrosio.
Congratulations.
Yasmin Dinesh. Nicholas Daniel D'Antonio. Wade Lewis Daniel.
Congratulations.
Joseph Andrew DeLorio. Adrian Noel David. Tremar Jarrell Davis.
Congratulations.
Alexander James Deladon. Kimberly Sitlali Diaz Duran. Connor McGrath Diamedio. Emily Janine DiFilippo. Joseph Matthew DiFilippo. Jonathan Robert Dixon. Catherine Adele Donnelly.
Congratulations.
Elliot Charles Dunn.
Congratulations.
Corinne Marie Eggers. Augustine Espinosa Ortiz. Marisol Esquivel Zavala. Ruben Estrada.
Congratulations.
Carly Grace Finelli.
Congratulations.
Zachary Daniel Felker.
Congratulations.
Trevor Michael Ferrero. Danielle Francis Feuda.
Congratulations.
Taylor Hope Finicaro. Aiden Joseph Firth.
Congratulations.
William Zachary Fisher.
Congratulations.
Alan Roman Flores.
Congratulations.
Nicholas DeBass Fogg.
Congratulations.
Sarah Fonseca Juarez. Benjamin Fitzpatrick Fox.
Congratulations.
Annika Lynn Franca.
Thank you so much. Congratulations. Congratulations.
Andrew Nicholas France Sullins. Roman A. Fuentes. Rachel Caroline Gable. Anthony James Geller. Sean Christopher Glatz. Cindy Gonzalez Arizaga. Thomas Robert Gordon. Madeline Elizabeth Grabluski. William Eric Gray.
Congratulations.
Madeline Rose Guido. Megan Harriet Gula. Tyler Thomas Guy. Livy Alexandra Hadzik.
Congratulations.
Abigail Ramsey Haynes. Joshua Thomas Hawks. Gary Paul Heiser.
Congratulations.
Andrew Breckenridge Hendricks. Isaiah Wayne Guy Hensley. Megan Francis Hepworth. Maria Diana Hernandez Castaneda. Karen Fernanda Herrera Zamudio. Joshua James Herring. Rowan Clayton Hershey.
Congratulations.
Aiden Thomas Holmes. Jacob Alexander Holmes. Logan Robert Hoops. Benjamin Michael Houghton. Cameron Michael Howard. Angela Lynn Hudson.
Congratulations.
Alana Faye Hughes. Sarah Ann Hughes. Sean Lee Holtberg.
Congratulations.
Zachary Michael Humphreys.
Congratulations.
Kevin Eugene Hunter. Cheyenne Zelina Hunter. Robert Dylan Huss. Lindsay Skylar Marie Hutchinson. Brian Ibarra Rosiles. Abigail Nianchoka Zawadi Ezeboke.
Congratulations.
Adon Jr. Anthony Diogo Terrio Jacinto.
Congratulations.
Skylar Mackenzie Jackson. Jacqueline Elizabeth Jarvis.
Congratulations.
Morgan Taylor Jernigan.
Congratulations.
Jose Antonio Jimenez Bedoya. Sonia Guadalupe Jimenez Bedoya. Chloe Louise Johnson. Hannah Marie Johnson.
Congratulations.
James Thomas Johnston III.
Congratulations.
Emma Elizabeth Jones.
Congratulations.
James Anthony Jones.
Congratulations.
Maria Marisol Juarez.
Congratulations.
Mariah Margarita Juarez. Sisareth Kanamar Lapudi. Maggie Grace Keegan. Ryan Patrick Kelly. Alexandria Elizabeth Kellogg. Natalie Kathleen Kelmelis. Kyle Anthony Kennedy. Caitlin Nicole Klein.
Congratulations.
Nicholas Vincent Konitsky. Kayla Alexis Kyle. Landon Michael LaFrance. Nicholas James Lagana. Leah Catherine Lanahan. Joshua Michael LaPearl. Jackson Thomas Lozen. Nicole Marie Laws. Rachel Ann Lee.
Congratulations.
Eric Robert Lee.
Congratulations.
Chelsea Lynette Lemus Diaz. Rowdy Lemus Zavala.
Congratulations.
Edward Damian Leon. Michelle Jane Lesturgeon. Michael Anthony Liberator. Benjamin Kayoshi Lincoln. Jack Edward Lincoln. Eric Neil Linkmeyer.
Congratulations.
Dylan John Lichko.
Congratulations.
Oliver Lopez.
Congratulations.
Mauricio Alexander Lopez.
Congratulations.
Yureli Montserrat Lopez Magana. Liam Anthony Ludwig. Brian Luna Valente. Chloe Elizabeth Mahala. Morgan Olivia Malchion. Jalen Ana E. Marcelo Zavala. Jessica Marcelo Hernandez. Jocelyn Veneza Martinez.
Congratulations.
Jacqueline Alexis Martinez.
Congratulations.
Sarah E. Martinez Ayala.
Congratulations.
Christopher Martinez Garcia.
Congratulations.
Brandon Michael Mayer. Emily Elizabeth McCaslin. Evan Michael McCleary. Lila Mulhern McCulley.
Congratulations.
Sydney Jane McGill. Brianna Renee McEwen. Sophia Jane McLaughlin. Jose Julian Medina Vasquez.
Congratulations.
Ariana Andriana Mejias Toro.
Congratulations. Congratulations.
Antonio Mendez. Leavine Mendoza Cruz.
Congratulations.
Sean Lewis Miller. Stephen Thomas Menino. Eduardo Miranda Morales. Alessandra Isabella Mitchell. Melinda Mondragon Gardunio. Brooklyn Marie Moore. Christopher Morales Hernandez. Gabriella Jubilee Morales Coyle. Andrew William Morrison. Meredith Joe Mulder. Calliope Jane Mozillo Dibert. Robert Thomas Murphy. Madison Elizabeth Muscolino. Luke Robert Nelson. Catherine Quinn Nolan. Michael Anthony Norris.
Congratulations.
Dylan Tate Novak. Eileen Mary Obetz. Megan Suzanne Obetz. Julia Guadalupe Ocampo Trujillo. Molly Elizabeth O'Connor. Avery Elizabeth O'Hare. Margaret Rose Olivero. Giselle Olmedo.
Congratulations.
Victoria Grace Olsky. Sophia Adriana Omar. Lauren Bailey O'Neill. Belinda Ortiz Aon.
Congratulations.
Yureli Ortiz Castaneda.
Congratulations.
Jessica Jesus Pantoja Fernandez. Jameer Calvin Payon.
Congratulations.
Priya Patel.
Congratulations.
Jack Garrett Pavlock.
Congratulations.
Natalie Ann Pearson.
Congratulations.
Barry Lee Pearson III.
Congratulations.
Angel Gabriel Pena Martinez. Montserrat Guadalupe Peralta Vega. Luis Alberto Perez Acosta. Kyle Joseph Perlman. Liam James Perrin. Samuel Emery Phoebe. Gianna Marie Piazza. Anna Grace Province. Maggie Grace Pizwara.
Congratulations.
Julia Diane Quirk.
Congratulations.
Jesus Adrian Ramirez Quintino. Matthew Stephen Rain.
Congratulations.
Joseph Andrew Rea.
Congratulations.
Sebastian Michael Rector.
Congratulations.
Brian John Reed. Sarah Elizabeth Reynolds.
Congratulations.
Anna E. Reza.
Congratulations.
Colby Wayne Riddell.
Congratulations.
Zachary Richard Rainier.
Congratulations.
Ariana Talia Rivera.
Congratulations.
Brett Andrew Ross.
Congratulations.
Connor Earl Ruark.
Congratulations. Here we go.
Christian Ruiz.
Congratulations.
Bridget Celine Salazar Garcia. Leslie Sanchez. Daisy Sanchez Diaz.
Congratulations.
Aaron Jeffrey Scheit.
Congratulations.
Tristan Tyler Sensenig.
Congratulations.
Kai Thomas Sharp.
Congratulations.
Theodore Johnston Schisler.
Congratulations.
Gabriel James Singer.
Congratulations.
Matthew Thomas Singer.
Congratulations.
Emily Morgan Slayman.
Congratulations.
Joseph Owen Smiley. Robert Aaron Smith.
Congratulations, and thank you for your service.
Jessica E. Smith. Victoria Lee Snader. Ronald Dean Sneed.
Congratulations.
Danielle Pamela Sorg. Kimberly Ann Spangler.
Congratulations.
Christopher James Spencer. Grayson Anthony Sprinkle. Amanda Nicole Starkey. Claire Madison Stern.
Congratulations.
Richard Allen Stoner Jr. Jacob Rushton Stretch. Luke Naveen Subramanian. Philomena Rose Suglia. Kylie Grace Sullivan. Casey Scott Sweeney.
Congratulations.
Richard Stinson Swires.
Congratulations.
Kirsty Ali Shefchik.
Congratulations.
Brooke Madison Taylor.
Congratulations.
Daniel Earl Taylor.
Congratulations.
Sitlali Tellez Rodriguez.
Congratulations.
Danielle Marie Templin.
Congratulations.
June Emily Thorngate.
Congratulations.
Ajane Neve Torres.
Congratulations.
Jennifer Torres Aon.
Congratulations.
Dylan Caesar Tran.
Congratulations.
Grace Elizabeth Troutman.
Congratulations.
Philip Nicholas Travaglini.
Congratulations.
Iran Trujillo Gallardo. Gabriella Nicole Tucci.
Congratulations.
Tyler Allen Umbach.
Congratulations.
Dane Upadia. Teo Lewis Van Golen. Hannah Marie Van Lith.
Congratulations.
Fallon Ann Vanderpool.
Congratulations.
Eric Francisco Vasquez León. Julia Carolyn Vino.
Congratulations.
Edine Atenanel Velasquez Gonzalez. Brian Vergara Vargas. Dylan Tyler Vernon.
Ashley, can you slow down a little? Scott's asking.
Emiliano Villagomez Lopez.
Congratulations.
Jake Michael Vitone.
Congratulations.
Samantha Ann Volker.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Cole Allen Wagoner.
Congratulations.
Lindsay Nicole Watson.
Congratulations.
Olivia Rose Watson.
Congratulations.
Sydney Ray Wayland.
Congratulations.
Kylie Catherine Weatherall.
Congratulations.
Eugene Russell Weaver.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Haley Brianna Weber.
Congratulations.
Dean Charles Wheeler.
Congratulations.
Tyler Edward Wersinski.
Congratulations.
Seth Lewis Williams. Spencer Kelly Woodward. Sean Matthew Wright.
Congratulations.
Nicole Zamoras Chavez. Javier Isidro Zavala.
Congratulations.
Jorge Zavala Gonzalez.
Congratulations.
Samantha Zavala Torres.
Congratulations.
Ivan Zavala Zavala.
Congratulations.
Nolan Lane Zotter.
Congratulations.
To do the tassel thing, so I'm going to do this. I'll tell them. Whether it works out, I don't know.
Avon Grove High School class of 2021, please rise. The moving of the tassel at graduation symbolizes one's transition from student to graduate. Students, at this time, please move your tassel from the right to the left. Congratulations to the Avon Grove High School class of 2021. Audience, please stand if you are able as we listen to the Avon Grove Chorale perform the alma mater. The words to the alma mater are in your program. Again, thank you. Congratulations. This concludes today's ceremony.